On the agenda tonight, we're going back to 2016. We're going to be taking a look at Tommy Shaw and the Cleveland-based Contemporary Youth Orchestra performing Fooling Yourself, The Angry Young Man. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So, let's get everybody up on screen and see how they get on. Going to jump in here. As always, the link to this video is going to be in the description below, so you can watch it there the whole way through without me interrupting it. And this is such a difficult one to jump into because of the overall performance. Just what I love to see is kids just enjoying playing music, and this kind of setup does hit a bit of a chord with me, because having taught guitar for so long, I've had so many students who have come to me really through their parents approaching me saying that they want to play music, but at school they've been put off because of the lack of enjoyment and the focus on theory, so that they go in to play an instrument and they're all excited about learning to play and making music, and then they sit down with a book and they have to learn scales and they have to learn the notes and they have to learn how to read music, and they don't really want to do that, they just want to play something. So this for me is the best of both worlds, where you get the contemporary youth orchestra, they're playing something contemporary, just getting into it, and it's all about enjoyment. That is what music is all about, and learning to play an instrument as well. You'll never find anybody in the world who has ever become the best at something because they hated doing it. It's just about enjoying something first. It doesn't matter what it is in life. If you have a passion for something, just do it and make sure you enjoy it. And once you enjoy it, you will become better at it and you will become very good at it, because you're doing it for the right reason in the first place. If you enjoy something, you'll keep on doing it and therefore you will improve. And the more you improve, the more you enjoy it. So it's a win-win situation. Let me also mention Will Ivankovic, who sat next to Tommy here on that second acoustic guitar. And obviously Tommy's name came up in the Sticks video that I did when I focused on Dennis DeYoung playing Babe behind the piano. So you can check that video out independently if you want to. But Tommy Shaw, his vocal ability, his range as well. I do have a cover of a Damn Yankees tune here somewhere on the channel, and that was Silence is Broken. His range, his control, the ease at which he's hitting these notes. We're talking about A4s here consistently, so it's up there in the tenor range, and you might find that if you are taking on any song that Tommy's singing, you'll have to adjust it for your own range, because he can hit those notes. He can soar well up there. To give you an idea of the range that Tommy's covering here, just in the first verse, he goes all the way from an A4 down to an F sharp 3. So you've got over an octave there, and the way that he throws it in there is so relaxed, you won't notice it at all. But we've got the kind of range that most singers are aiming for to take their verse into a chorus, having that one octave jump, whereas Tommy has that kind of control and ability where he'll throw in over an octave change without you even noticing it, because of his consistency vocally and just the ease with which he produces these notes. To give an example of that, it is straight off the bat in the first verse, where we have, "You see the world through your cynical eyes, you're a troubled young man, I can tell." And that is the range that's being covered there is over an octave. Obviously, Tommy makes this sound so easy, but when you work your way up to the cynical eyes, when we go, "You see the world through your cynical eyes," that's on the way down from the A4. So such range and control that Tommy has. And then when he goes down to, "You're a troubled young man," that dive down, it is such a pitch change, but his tone is so consistent, you don't really take that in. But this is one of those videos that is so difficult to approach from an analytical perspective, because there's so much we could focus on. Just the vocals that Tommy's laying down, the guitar work as well. Maybe I'll get out the guitar, just play through a riff or two. But then also time signatures. I'm going to spend a little bit talking about that, because we have a few time signature changes here, which means that it's a good way to demonstrate to you guys, if you don't know what they are, how to count along with this particular composition. So the composition starts in 6/8. That is the time signature, which is just double 3/4. And 3/4 is a time signature that I have mentioned quite a lot here on the channel before, but you just count up to three. So you go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Just keep on counting like that and you are in 3/4. So if you do take 3/4, you double 3, you get a 6, then you double 4 and you get an 8. So 6/8 as a time signature is the same as 3/4, but instead of starting again after 3 and going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you just count to 6 and make that the end of the bar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. I'm going to play the video and I will call out the numbers so that maybe you can start to get into the feel of it and the groove. You'll find that just counting up to three, you'll start to get into it and understand where you are. But then as soon as you count up to six, and rather than going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you'll now find that it all slots in place. But let's get this going. You start to get the idea. So, if you are counting along with that, you'll be able to tap your foot to it because you know where the beginning of each bar is and how long it lasts for. So, as we get into the verse, we then convert into a standard 4-4 time signature, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just every pop song pretty much ever, but we'll play a bit of this video and just count along these four beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. You start to get the idea. Another time signature that we can get into is in the solo section, and this is 7-4. So no prizes for guessing what we're going to be counting up to now, considering that in 3-4 you count up to 3, in 4-4 you count up to 4, in 6-8 you count up to 6, in 7-4 you count up to 7. So I'll play the video and just say the beats so you get a bit of a vibe as to what's going on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2. You start to get the idea. We're just counting up to 7. So hopefully it's starting to make a little bit of sense as to what happens with time signatures. You just follow the number at the beginning. If you count to that, you'll be able to tap your foot along to whatever's being played. There actually is another time signature that happens briefly in this song, and it's 5-4. So without telling you the answer, hopefully you'll know that in 3-4, count to 3, in 4-4, count to 4, in 5-4, you count to 5, and maybe you've already worked that out. But let's watch the video until the end.
Oh,
have it. What a great version of the song that was. And I think if I was there, my head would have exploded at the end because of the amount that is going on here. Also, just being right down my street in terms of the music as well, with Tommy's voice, the guitar in there, the riff. There's so much going on here. Let's also mention the talent in the youth orchestra, because this is by no way a performance that you would attribute to children or youths playing it. If you weren't looking at the screen, you would say that this is a professional orchestra and it has been arranged professionally, and the talent on show here is just on a different level. I know that this video has probably already gone on for a while, but I'm going to show you the guitar parts really quickly. It's not going to be an instructional video, but just the shapes that are going on here. Pretty much we've got everything in D, by the way. We want to have the low E string tuned down to D here in order to play along. So standard tuning for the rest of the strings, but then drop D. So you want that low E string to be a D, which means that when you play your D chord, you can go all the way across the guitar and play all of those strings. So starting out with the intro, obviously with the orchestra, it's hard to make out what's going on, but we've pretty much got that kind of sound, which is just the octaves and the fifths. There's nothing really going on here too technical. You just want to make sure that you're squashing down your first finger on the seventh fret as far as the D string. So you get that sound, but then placing on your little finger is going to give you the octave of the two notes you're holding down with the first finger. So it means that all the way across now, you get that sound. And my little finger is just barring on the 10th fret, the high E string and the B string. Tommy also goes down to the G down at the bottom. And the important thing to remember about this is that you don't want to hit your low E string, or if you are hitting it, make sure you're muting it. So you can mute it with the side of your first finger or with your thumb, and just playing from that second string down is probably your best bet. So the A string, like that. So as you can hear, that second time I hit that low E string, but because it's muted, it doesn't ring out. But let's fast forward into the riff that we have in the intro, and this is going to be a little bit more technical, a bit more fancy. You have to move it around and be aware of the time signature that you're playing in, because when you play through it, that's the way that it progresses. I'll slow that down, and you're just going to be repeating this over and over again. Actually, the second time we play through it, we've got this. Like that. So, breaking that down, the first part through the second part, we've got our D, and we want to shift up to our simplified G shape here, really, but you've got your first finger across the G, the B, and the high E string, placing that second finger. And again, you can hit the strings all the way across here, and then you're going to be moving up exactly the same shape, and then squash down that third finger on the seventh fret, back down. Like that. So playing it through slowly, we've got our D, and as you can see here, I'm barring with my first finger and placing in my second finger, because it means that getting to the next shape, it's just going to be a case of moving my hand up one fret and moving the second finger to the G string. Like that. So slowly we've got that. Let me just explain this shape. Second fret of the A string, which is our B, we're playing there, and with the third finger I'm playing my D, third fret of the B string, and I'm just going same shape up two frets. Second time through, we're going back into the same shape that I played with the D. Go back down again, and we go like that. So that was just second fret. If you're looking at my first finger, with that first finger, and then you're pretty much through it. There is another riff that we've got in there as well that is just the D. And just placing the first finger on the first fret of your B string in order to get that C there. And we've got... that kind of vibe. Obviously, there is so much in this performance, I can't really get through it all, but those are the main elements. We're just gonna need really that same D chord, and these shapes are just gonna be repeating pretty much throughout the whole song. We've also got in the pre-chorus a bar chord here, which is gonna be our B flat, but we do move up to what sounds like a C, but the bass doesn't change. So you might want to play your B flat and then just play the first fret with your first finger to get that root note and place in the second finger where we just played that C on the other chord. And you'll get that sound. Which will go a little bit better with the performance and with the overall sound. Just quickly, the get up part as well, where everyone gets involved. Tommy's just playing a D here. Just keep that same shape. Like that, and jumping over to the G. And again, just from the A string here, so you're going from your B with the first finger, second fret of the A string, into a C. Like that. The part of the song that I'm talking about is the melody that's not played on the guitar, but it's this. That's where those chords come in. But like I said, this could go on for years, this video. There's so much to look at. And I was gonna get into Tommy's history and his career, but that isn't gonna happen on this video because we would be here all day, maybe even all week. But thank you guys so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!